Happy morning, everyone. Welcome back to Blue Stars Higher Secondary School English Online Class. Today, we are going to learn conditional class, conditional sentences in English. The order of the two classes is flexible. When the if class comes first, it must be followed by a comma. So the order of the two class is flexible. When the if class comes first, it must be followed by a comma. You can see the example. If it rains, so after the if class, we have to put comma. I will stay at home. Then I will stay at home if it rains. So the order of the two classes here is flexible. When the if class comes first, it must be followed by a comma. So in this sentence, you can see if it rains. So here if class it comes first, so it must be followed by a comma. Next, the structure of the conditional sentence. A conditional sentence is composed of two parts. What are they? If class plus main class. So you can see the example. If it rains tomorrow, we will put on raincoats. So here, if it rains tomorrow, so it is a if class. We will put on raincoats. It is a main class because it gives a complete meaning. So a conditional sentence is composed of two parts, that is if class plus main class. And if it rains tomorrow, we will put on raincoats. So it is a if class and it is main class. Main class is nothing but it gives a complete meaning. Next, the conditionals are used to talk about real or unreal situations, sometimes called if classes. So the conditionals are used to talk about real or unreal situations, sometimes called if classes. Used to show an action is reliant on something else. So real conditional describes real life situations. Unreal conditional describes unreal imaginary situation. So real conditional describes real life situations and unreal conditional describes unreal imaginary situations. So we are having four types here. There are four types of conditional sentences. They are classified according to the degree of probability that they express. So each type of conditional sentences uses different tenses to show the difference in the degree of probability. This is the structure. Conditional sentences type. We are having four types: zero conditional, first conditional, second conditional, and third conditional. So zero conditional, what is the structure? If or when plus present tense and are present tense. So we can see the example, water boils if it reaches 100 degree. Then the first conditional means likely to happen. Zero conditional means it is a factual act. Then first conditional means it is going to happen. If or unless plus present or future. If I study, I will pass. Then second conditional, hypothetical situations. If plus past, then when main class, would plus infinitive. If we won the lottery, we would travel the world. So it is a main class. So main class means it gives a complete meaning. Then third conditional means impossible conditional. If plus past perfect in royal writing in main class would have plus past participle. That is, if I had studied, I would have passed. So it is a main class. I would have passed is a main class. So here, zero conditional and first conditional is real conditionals, and second conditional and third conditional are considered as a unreal conditionals. So what is mean by zero conditional? It is used to talk about things that are always true or factual. It is scientific facts, general or universal truth. So zero conditional is nothing but it is used to talk about things that are always true or factual, scientific facts, general or universal truth. The structure is present simple plus present simple. For example, if you see here, if you expose phosphorus to air, it burns. So it is also a present simple and it is also a present simple. So it is a zero condition is used to talk about things that are always true or factual. That is in scientific facts, general or universal truth. So we cannot change that. Next one is first conditional means very likely situation. It is used to talk about situations which are very likely to happen. So first conditional is used to talk about situations which are very likely to happen, giving advice and instructions. Then suggest something which is unlikely to happen. Then talk about the result of a situation which is just a possibility. Talk about present decisions based on future abilities. So these are called as first conditional means very likely situation, and it is used to talk about situation which are very likely to happen, and will be giving advice and instructions. Suggest something which is unlikely to happen. Talk about the result of a situation which is just a possibility. Then fifth one is talk about present decisions based on future abilities. So possible sentence structure. What is the structure? If plus simple present plus will. So here both condition and result are very likely to happen. Here you can see the example. If Javed gets a good result, he will study medicine. So here if plus simple present. What is the simple present here? Gets. And plus will. So main in the main class you are using future tense will. If he fails his exams, he will not go abroad. So in second sentence, if plus simple present plus imperative. This is a way of giving advice or instructions. If you feel tired, drink a cup of coffee. So it is a way of giving advice or instructions. If you can't wake up, buy an alarm clock. If you see my wife, tell her I will be late for dinner. So this is the structure for possible sentence. That is if plus simple present plus will. Then if plus simple present plus imperative. Then if plus should plus imperative. In this way, we can suggest that something is unlikely to happen or is not particularly probable. For example, if you should run into Peter, tell him he owes me a letter. So we can suggest that something is unlikely to happen or is not a particular probable. So in the next sentence, if plus simple present plus may. The result of the condition is just a possibility. For example, if we go to writing workshop, we may not get time to shop. If we don't give them directions, they may get lost. So here, if plus simple present plus may. So in this, the result of the condition is just a possibility. Next one is if plus simple present plus can or would. We use this form when we make present decisions about future ability. Otherwise, we use will be able to. For example, if I have not enough time today, I can wash your car tomorrow. So here, when we make present decisions about the our future ability, if I have not enough time today, I can wash your car tomorrow. So in this, we have used if plus simple present plus can or would. A sentence structure in first conditional. So if plus simple present plus will. So what is the function? Both conditions or results are very likely to happen. Then if plus simple present plus imperative, giving advice or instructions. If plus should plus imperative, to suggest that something is unlikely to happen. Then if plus simple present plus may, the result of the condition is just a possibility. Then if plus simple present plus can to talk about present decisions based on future ability. Next one is second conditional, that is hypothetical situation. It is used to talk about unreal or impossible situation in present or future. These structures are used to imagine what would be like if things were different. For example, if I were rich, I would travel around the world. If I have a car, I could drive you home. So it is used to talk about unreal or impossible situation in present or future. So what's the structure here? If plus simple past plus would. Example, if I were the president, I would end unemployment. If I won the lottery, I would buy a Ferrari. If I were you, I would start packing now. So these are the example for if plus simple past plus would. So in the main class, we are using would. Next one, if plus simple past plus might. The result of the condition would be just a possibility. So it might can be used as a possibility. For example, if you drove with drowsy head, you might have an accident. If you were not so selfish, you might be happier. So here, if plus simple past plus might, the result of the condition would be just a possibility. So if you drove with drowsy head, you might have an accident. It is possible to have an accident. If you were not so selfish, you might be happier. Next one is if plus simple past plus could. The meaning of could here is would be able to. So here could can be considered as an would be able to. For example, if I had another 1,000 rupees, I could buy the latest edition of this book. Then I could have passed my CSS exam if I had another month for preparation. So it can I can be able to do that things. So that is the meaning of that. Then if plus were to plus would. This makes a future possibility sound less probable. For example, if world war were to break out, I would emigrate to Mars. So this makes a future possibility sound less probable. Means if world war were to break out, I would emigrate to Mars. Next one, the structure for possible sentence structure for second conditions, that is if plus simple past plus would. What's the function? To imagine what would be like if things were different. Then if plus simple past plus might. The result of a condition in past would be just a possibility. Then if plus simple past plus could. To talk about a past ability with a hypothetical condition. Then if back to plus would means to talk about a less probable future possibility. So what is the third conditional? It is used to talk about conditions which didn't happen in the past and so the result did not happen either. It is used for speculating about past events. So third conditional is used to talk about conditions which didn't happen in the past and so the result did not happen either. It is used for speculating about past events. For example, if you had not been lazy, you would have been on time for the audition. If he had come earlier, he could have had a free lunch. Next, what's the structure? If plus past perfect plus perfect conditional. If he had studied, he would have passed. Then if plus past perfect plus might have. If someone had heard the SOS, their lives might have been saved. Then if plus past perfect plus could have been means here able to. If my parents had not been poor, I could have gone to university. So this is a structure for that. What is structure for third conditional? Here you can see possible sentence structure for third conditional. If plus past perfect plus perfect conditional, that is would have. These structures are used to talk about the conditions which did not happen in past. Then if plus past perfect plus might have. These structures are used to talk about past regrets and to criticize past actions. So if plus past perfect plus could have. Then make a conditioned sentence based on information provided in given sentence. So what is that? So you can see this. Nobody told me about your birthday, and so I asked you to have an official tour out of city. Then there was no chance of rescuing survivors, and so they called off the search. Ali was suddenly taken ill, and so he and his family did not go on holiday to Muri Hills. So this is a sentence by making a condition sentence based on information provided in given sentences. So other words to use to for showing condition. What are the other words which can be used for showing condition? Means these are the words: provided, providing, supposing, as long as, on condition, that. So these words are used to show for showing condition. For example, supposing you fell into a water pool on a winter morning, what would you do? So here supposing is used for condition, showing condition. Then you can borrow my bike, provided or providing you bring it back. So here provided or providing is considered as a condition. Then I will give you the day off on condition that you work on Saturday morning. Here on condition that is considered as a condition. Then you are welcome to stay with us as long as you share the rent. So here as long as. So these words are used or words to used for showing conditions. What are the words? Provided, providing, supposing, as long as, on condition that. Next one is the risk. Again, we can see zero condition. What is the probability? Certain. That is, example, if you heat water to 100 degrees Celsius, it boils. So the time is maybe, it may be any time. Then first condition means likely. If it rains, I will stay in. So it represents future. Then second means unlikely. If I won the lottery, I would retire. So this also represents future. Then second condition, impossible. If I had the money, I would lend it to you. So that is in present. Third, impossible. If I had seen him, I would have given him the message. This is a past time. So hope you would have all understood the conditional, students. So read the structure and write it in your notebook, students. Thank you, students. Have a good day.